have two electrical motors whose bearings I want to replace. They are rather old and the bearings in the small motor have already seized. Warning, I am not a professional. I don't know what I am doing. You should probably not do what I am about to do. There are better bearing removal videos on YouTube. I first take apart the larger of the two motors. I then begin taking apart the second motor. It was then time to remove the bearings from the rotor shaft of the larger motor. I got this really cheap imported 3-pronged extractor to try. I managed to get the smaller of the two bearings off rather easily. The larger bearing was more of a challenge. Here's a look at the crappy extractor. The center hole is not even centered. I'm no expert, but something tells me this hole is not supposed to be eccentric. On the stator for the second motor, the extractor was not long enough for the first bearing. So I decided to try and force it with a wood clamp. I finally forced it enough with the wood clamp so that I can get my crappy extractor on it. The first bearing off, I moved to the second and final bearing. This one proved to be a nasty challenge. It was the one that was seized. I couldn't get it to come off with the extractor. I tried even spraying it with a degreaser and trying to heat it up and force it out. I then moved on to more extreme means in the way of a grinder with a cutoff wheel. The outer race was easy to remove, but the inside one was much harder as it was right on the shaft. And here's the result. I cut off some of the rotor shaft because I'm an idiot. Luckily, there was enough shaft diameter left. The larger motor had bearings made in Romania by URB. The second motor had a German FAG bearing and a Japanese Koyo bearing that I cut apart. I'm replacing them all with Swedish SKF bearings made in Bulgaria and Italy. Go figure. I lightly cleaned the shaft with some steel wool and inserted both bearings. In order to reseat the bearings, I tried a wide variety of combinations from tapping with a hammer on a piece of wood and using the wood clamps. In the end, for the small bearing, a copper pipe and a hammer tap worked best, and for the larger bearing, tapping on a wrench. With the bearings replaced on the rotor shafts, I reassembled the motors. I wired them in and tested them. The larger motor runs at around 3000 RPM, which means it is a two-pole, three-phase induction motor. The smaller motor runs at around 1500 RPM, which means it is a 4-pole, 3-phase induction motor. Hey, thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Also, make sure to turn on notifications to receive updates whenever I post a new video. If you like what you saw, hit that like button as well.